After the GT40, Ford decided to experiment with the GT name. In 1970, they came out with the GT70, which was a rally spec car meant to compete against Porsche and Renault on the WRC. In 1995, they came out with the GT90, which was based on the Jaguar XJ220 platform. It had a V12 quad turbo engine that allowed that car to put up speeds like 253 miles an hour. In 1995, that is the fastest car in the world. Unfortunately, both cars were scrapped and neither of them made it to production. During its centennial in 2002, Ford unveiled the GT40 concept. Now, this had all the best features of the original GT, right down to the height. The original GT was 40 inches off the ground, the new one, 44. Finally, after nearly 60 years from beating Ferrari at the 1966 Le Mans, the GT went into production. And this is what they came up with. They had Ford's 5.4 liter V8 in them. Now, a lot of people thought that this was the same engine that they put in the F-150. However, this one was made out of aluminum alloy, which made it incredibly light. The V8 was supercharged, which means that this thing put out 550 horsepower and 500 pound-feet of torque. It could go 0 to 100 in 3.3 seconds and took it all the way to a top speed of 205 miles an hour. Now, this 2006 is old news. I know you guys have been excited for the 2019 to arrive here, which I have been told will be here in the next couple weeks. And these are the options we've chose.
The color will be liquid blue. The interior is called Lightspeed, which features black and navy highlights. 20-inch graphite wheels, red Brembo brake calipers, and a matte exposed carbon fiber exterior finish. As I mentioned, it will be showing up in the next couple weeks, so make sure to keep an eye on our social media. This is one you won't want to miss.